Freemotion is a real-time rendering software, so having the need to have a constantly rendered 3D model requires hardware to run smoothly. On the official website of Freemotion, on which I'll leave you the link in the description, the system requirements with both minimal and high performance are given, and broadly speaking, the features are similar on both Windows and Mac. In this first part, I'll point out that under both the graphic cards, GPU and processor, CPU, a certain score is required as a benchmark. To simplify, the benchmark is a score that in this case is given to processor and graphic cards. The higher the score, the better the performance of using both Freemotion, but also any other application on your PC. Freemotion, however, is a software that relies primarily on graphic cards, so if you were to make an investment, I would recommend that you do so on graphic card itself. Specifically, clicking on the link to the World Graphic Card Benchmark opens a new web page with rankings of all the graphic cards currently on the market. The benchmark of a GPU corresponds to the number you see next to the colored bars. For example, the best graphic card out there, the GeForce RTX 4090, has a benchmark of almost 39k points, with about 24GB of RAM. Use Freemotion with minimum performance, a benchmark of at least 10,000 points is required. Indicatively, it is recommended that you have a graphic card that is equal to or higher than the GeForce GTX 1060 in the rankings. In addition to this, affecting the performance of Freemotion is also the GPU's RAM, which, with minimum requirements, is recommended to have at least 6. Having a good graphic card will not only allow you to be faster in using Freemotion, but also to use the Lumen and PathTracer rendering engines. PathTracer is the photorealism engine, and is only supported on graphic cards with at least 8GB of RAM, supporting DirectX 12, NVIDIA RTX, or AMD RX 6000 series or higher. Unfortunately, on Mac it is not supported, but not at behest of Epic Games, simply because Apple doesn't support hardware-accelerated ray tracing. In conclusion, in case your PC meets the requirements to use the PathTracer, to activate it in Freemotion, you just need to click on the Edit menu, Preferences, Graphic Card Support, and turn on the box mark on DirectX 12. Then, start the application. Despite this, however, on both Windows and Mac, it is possible to use the Lumen engine, which gives renderings a quality almost comparable to that of PathTracer. On Windows, the requirements are similar to those of PathTracer. On Mac, however, a dedicated graphic card is recommended. In order to enable the Lumen rendering engine, click on the Edit menu, Preferences, Quality, and set the quality High to Ultra. In conclusion, to use Freemotion to its full potential, obviously, I recommend the Windows operating system, but above all, consider a GPU with at least 20 or 25,000 benchmark points, and with a RAM with at least 12GB. For example, I use a GeForce RTX 4080 laptop, and I have never had stability problems, even with large projects. As for the RAM of the PC, I recommend at least 64GB. As far as I know, the processor has never negatively affected the use of Freemotion, simply because the requirements are very low. I'd like to take just 20 seconds, I promise, to inform you that I'm creating the Freemotion Masterclass Learning Portal, where I will guide you through the fantastic world of Freemotion, whether you're a beginner or an expert. Click on the link in the description of this video to stay updated on all the news and secure an exclusive discount at launch. Pre-register now using your email. Thank you so much for the support and enjoy the video. In addition to all this, however, it is of paramount importance to keep your graphic card driver updated over time, always to the latest version available. This will improve the performance of Freemotion's rendering engines, allow you to move through the scene more fluidly, and are often the solution to problems of sudden program crashes, or bugs, discovered during use. I recommend that you update graphic card's driver directly from the official provider website, not through your operating system's automatic tools, to avoid installing unwanted components. In my case, I go to the NVIDIA driver download site, filter the search by respect to my graphic card, and download the latest available driver. Once downloaded and started the installation, from my experience, I recommend you to do an installation without GeForce Experience, so you will avoid that automatically the system updates the driver every time new updates are released. Do a custom installation and then a clean installation to delete all versions of drivers that, in addition to taking space on your PC disk, can create conflicts between versions. Once installed, restart your PC. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed, subscribe so you don't miss any future content. Like the video so you can help me with the algorithm, and write me in the comment what topic you'd like me to cover in the next video. That said, I wish you a good day or evening, and see you very, very soon. Ciao!